said, your time's coming to an end. Summer's come and you did nothing about it. Harvest time's past. And you're still not saved. What are you waiting on? I don't care how long you've been to church. I don't care how long you've taught Sunday school. I don't care how many terms you've served as deacon. I don't care how many times you've sung in the choir. I do care, are you saved? Is Jesus the lover of your soul? If he's the lover of your soul, you can't do what you want to do. If he's the lover of your soul, you cannot do what you want to do. You cannot go where you want to go. You are connected to him. Summer's coming. The harvest is past. You've come in and out of these doors for 6 years and you're still not saved. But the joy is about to turn to mourning. The joy is about to change in your situations. Jesus is coming. You won't stand before Jesus and say, you know, I didn't know, I didn't hear it. You won't stand before him with excuse saying, I didn't do nothing. The preacher didn't preach the truth. The preacher didn't say what I needed to do. You will not stand and say, Sam Henderson didn't preach you the truth this morning. You will not stand before him. It's turned, isn't it, sister? Since my people, but listen, and you know, can you imagine how tough that was for Jeremiah to have to send that out? Can you imagine how tough it is to give this message to the people? I feel his pain this morning. It's not easy telling people, listen, this is what's coming. I mean, it's the easiest thing for me to do this morning is to pacify you and just get me out a little Band-Aid and stick it on your situation and say, let's hope this will heal it up. Let's hope this Band-Aid will fix it. And that's the problem as a church. It looks like a Band-Aid commercial. The church looks like a Band-Aid commercial. Because preachers are just allowing people just to give them those sob stories and those pitiful little stories, and they'll say, oh, let's just stick a Band-Aid on it, and maybe it'll go away over time. Listen to what he said right here. Jeremiah said, since my people are crushed, I'm crushed. I mourn, and horror grips me. The King James says, I'm black. He's talking about, you know, he's mourning. I'm walking around in black. I'm black. I'm mourning. That's what it's saying. Some of you are saying, well, my Bible didn't say that. I'm just using the NIV this morning because it says this. I'm mourning. I'm hurting. I'm hurting for the people. I'm hurting for the people. Listen, he sent out a warning with pain. I'm sending out this warning this morning because it hurts to send out this warning that the church is more in trouble, as much trouble as the world. Since my people are crushed, I'm crushed, I mourn, and horror grips me. Listen to this. Is there no balm in Gilead? Is there no physician there? Then why is there no healing for the womb of my people? Yes, there was balm there. The blood of Jesus is the balm. Yes, there was balm there, but they didn't want the balm. They didn't want the healing. Yes, there was balm in Gilead. Yes, there was some salve in Gilead. Yes, there was something that would heal their wounds. Yes, there was something in Gilead. Yes, there's something in Henrietta this morning. Yes, there's something in Rutherford County this morning. Yes, there's something in North Carolina this morning. Yes, there's something in America this morning. But the problem is nobody wants what will fix their wounds. They just want somebody to say, here, put some gauze on it, put a Band-Aid on it, and walk away. But I'm going to tell you something. The only thing that's going to fix your situation is the blood that was shed on the cross of Calvary. The balm that was in Gilead is the same balm that is in Henrietta this morning. Is there no physician in Henrietta? Yes, Jesus Christ is a physician, but nobody wants to come to the physician. Nobody wants to come to the balm. Everybody wants a fix, but without going to the right place to get what they need. Yes, it's in the house this morning, but not many people want it. Is there no balm in Gilead? Why? Why have the people not turned? Oh, it was available to them. They just didn't want it. They done said, we're going to do our course. So I'm telling you, so that your blood won't drip from my hands. Everybody looking right at me, so your blood don't drip from my hands this morning. There is balm in Henrietta this morning. There is a physician in the house this morning. There is healing in this house this morning. I'm not talking about your cancer, and I'm not talking about your heart problem this morning. I'm talking about your spiritual healing this morning. Is there? Yes, there is. And that's what he was saying to him. Yes, there was an opportunity for him, and all they wanted was a Band-Aid. Some of you are in situations that you want a Band-Aid instead of the balm. You're wanting some pacifier instead of a physician. You'll run all over this house finding somebody that'll pet you up in your situation because you want a pacifier and not a doctor. You'll run to somebody and let them stick a little bottle in your mouth again to pacify you instead of going to the doctor. The blood and Jesus is in the house. But are you going to be just like they were and say, I'll do my own course another day? You see, some of that conviction that walked out last week may never grace the doors of a church again. You might live to be 150, but you might not live 10 more minutes. You might say, I can choose my course a few more days. Maybe you can. You might choose your course 50 more years, but you might not. But you might not. And if Jesus is truly the lover of your soul, you won't want to choose your course. Because his ways are not your ways, and his thoughts are not our thoughts. And if he's the lover, that means he's directing and he's leading this thing. All you're doing is hanging on and saying, you're leading this thing, not me. Is he the lover of your soul? Come on, praise team. I want you to sing that song real low, not loud, just real low. Jesus, lover of my soul. The doors of the church are open, the altar's open. But more than anything, more than joining a church, I want to know, are you saved? I want to know, do you have a relationship with Jesus Christ? If you die today, would you go to heaven or hell? If you die today, will you go to heaven or hell? Have you chose your own course? I don't want nobody talking during this altar call. I don't want you whispering to the person beside of you. I don't want you whispering to the person beside of you. I don't want you looking around. Because I'm going to tell you something. There's somebody going to be willing to walk out of here lost this morning. And I need warriors.